Hi, I'm Gary White for Central Kentucky Television, again here with Yvonne McNary and yes. Beth Overhow for our Christmas Spectacular 2013, celebrating the holidays. We'll be talking about some fun stuff that we remember and are going to be doing and all that kind of stuff. And for the past several years, we've been doing our Christmas show. Mm-hmm. And several years back, actually, we were airing from 2007, 2008, some of our little talk segments there. We get to sing and dance there,
yes,
too.
We
always
did.
Have a lot of people come on and do that. We're not going to sing or dance today.
Aww.
You want to?
No.
I do have that choir, chorus, Christmas music.
That's right, I saw that.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so... So we're not going to sing or dance today, but...
Another
we do,
time.
Exactly. Okay. But we did have... I didn't get to play Snoopy. I'm going to play our Snoopy.
What, please?
Isn't that nice?
Oh, those are so lovely.
I wish my niece was playing.
They're so creepy.
I love it.
I think the music quality is incredible. I don't know if the viewers can really hear how good that music
is. Yeah,
you can tell what the instrument is and everything.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but they're all playing different instruments. What's your favorite Christmas song?
Probably Silent Night, probably.
Which we just heard.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
That's probably the first one I sort of learned was Silent Night. My grandma taught me. Well, funny story with Silent Night. I thought I knew the words because I learned it from my grandmother, and I just picked up the sounds from her, not really knowing the words.
And what they meant.
And when I finally got into school, and they passed out the music books at Christmas time, and it said Silent Night, I go, "It's not Silent Night." Something like them go like this. What's wrong with you people?
My name's not Holy.
No, that's not what that says. But anyway, you know, I realized then that I didn't really know Silent Night the way I thought I knew it,
right.
You know, so I didn't relearn it or relearn the tone, the music or anything, but just some of the words, you know, what they really did say, because where I would go, there actually was a word in there somewhere, you know, so I finally found all those words to that, and, but I was, you know, like really floored at that, so I was like, that can't be, that's Silent Night, you know, and... But, you know, at that time I was able to read for
I know what you're saying with the songs, because I know there are different songs that when I was a kid,
mm-hmm.
I would hear that. I don't remember a Christmas song particularly.
Right.
But, like, I do remember, like, Flashdance came out when I was, like, 8 or something like that. And the song, Oh, What a Feeling, and I thought they were saying other things in that song. I don't remember. Yeah. Don't remember what they were.
No, of course not.
But stuff like that, and you're like... Wow, that's what they're saying.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Hear a 5-year-old say the pledge, you know, and you get an idea of what it must be like.
Their perception and hear what they hear, what they're hearing is not...
They have to make it make sense to their world.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, it's like, that's why I enjoy sometimes going to some of our community theater events locally, mm-hmm. too. Like, for Les Miserables, there's some... You just miss some of the words that are being said there, but when you go to these things... they had to do it slower or something, so you can, like,
you
that's what
they
said.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Uh-huh.
And hearing different people sing different things, mm-hmm. sometimes they
Well, that's why I like karaoke. You know, the words are on the wall for you to...
Yeah.
That's not why you like karaoke.
Well, that's one reason I like karaoke.
And karaoke is something that you do every trip you take, right?
It's one of my trip traditions. Yes, I have three.
And the refreshments that go along with the karaoke?
Not so much anymore. That ended... About 6 years ago.
Okay. Okay.
I wonder why.
But you know, that's fun too. You know, we could have a Christmas karaoke where you sing only Christmas songs.
That would
songs.
Be fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Only Christmas songs, so that'd be good.
We could do
we'll
that
have a
next
Christmas
year.
Sing-off next year. Yeah,
right.
And people come on for competition.
Challenge
them.
Like
yeah. Yeah, challenge
sing
to
their
a Christmas,
Christmas
song. Yeah.
That'd be interesting.
But I have noticed on Channel 6 that we do have a lot of music, Christmas music, that
mm-hmm.
I've been watching here on the station, Central Kentucky Television. And going back a couple of years or so and seeing some of the kids' faces that I now know are,
adults.
You know, sometimes
yeah,
6 feet
adults.
Tall,
right.
You know, I'm thinking, is that... Couldn't be, you know, but it's wonderful, though, to be able to see that, you know, and I hope that some of the parents of those children are taking advantage of this because it really takes you back and then it takes
right.
you forward again, you know, to know that these kids have gone have come so far.
Well, Charlotte was in Bargetown singing with the Stephen
Foster.
Campbell.
Campbell.
And I didn't realize it until I zoomed in. And I went, well, there's little Charlotte, but she's 21 years old maybe now. And it's you know, it's like, oh my gosh.
Yes. She's a college student.
Yes, it is, but after getting old.
They grow up. Speaking of refreshments for the holidays, what's your favorite holiday refreshment? Like, do you like eggnog? Or do you like cider, hot chocolate, anything of that nature? Spiced wine or anything? No. Do you do any of those kind of drinks?
No, I don't want any of that.
You know, I remember Mom made, maybe 2 years in a row, made Cherry's Jubilee, and we were too young to like it, but it was fun to watch her light it, because you pour a sherry or something on top and light it.
Mm-hmm.
But it was nasty, you know, I could never,
yeah,
I was
I'm
too young to enjoy it, but it was like a tradition she tried to get going, it didn't take off.
Well, you know what I like, well, I went to a Christmas party not too long ago, and they had that lime sherbet punch.
Mm-hmm.
I like that. That
very was lime sherbet ginger ale.
Yeah, ginger ale. I like that. Yeah, give me that, and I'm fine.
Well, I've got a dilemma this year, actually, because we're not going up to Indianapolis, and it's just going to be my nuclear family, my two sons and daughter, and my daughter's girlfriend and my son's fiance, so a couple of strangers, too. But two of them are vegetarian. The rest of them don't like beef. You know, so that knocks out half of that. And one of them's allergic to shrimp. It's like, okay, what are we going
to
do?
Have them bring their own. Tell them to bring their own. Then they can, you can make sure that they get exactly what they want.
Because we always, 1 year, maybe we'll do fondue. You know, that's kind of a fun thing to do, and I could start a new tradition.
Have you ever made? But you need something to stick in it.
You do. I don't know what that would be.
Wouldn't be fish.
If it's cheese fondue, you could do vegetables. Fish. You know, like
marshmallows.
And then have another one, a pot for the people that can eat shrimp and chicken. I could do that. That might be different. I'll think on it.
Yeah.
If you have any ideas, you can give me a call.
Yeah, that's hard.
Yeah. At Christmas morning, we always had cheese souffle. Never without, every year.
Cheese souffle.
And salmon with capers and onions.
That'd be good. Salmon. Mm-hmm. On Christmas morning, is that
true? That's part of the tradition. Huh. And I guess I'll still do that if I can find the salmon.
I like breakfast casserole. You know, I'd like to have that on
Christmas. I saw an interesting breakfast casserole they made in a crock pot on Facebook the other day. I'll forward it to you because you cook it overnight and it's got everything in it.
Yeah, because I'm going to get a new crock pot for Christmas this year. That's what I'm getting myself.
Well, good. Get it a few days earlier so you can try this casserole.
Crock pots are really taking off.
Well, mine's already always taken off because when you work, you put it in, you know, you have your dinner ready by the time you get home from work. So
right.
So it's always worked well for me, but the
elements going bad?
No, it's the stick-free
on
the inside.
Yeah, after a while.
I think I've eaten most of it.
All kinds of new ones.
The same thing with my George. You know, I use it all the time, you know, because, you know, for one or two people, you have your George.
George is getting sticky.
I've eaten it all, you know, the covering off there. Where'd it go? So now I'm having to spray the thing with, you know, trying to. So
I see you mean George Foreman.
Foreman.
Yeah,
yes.
Grill.
Yeah, that too. Yes.
My mom would always make coffee cake.
And she made it?
Wow. From, I guess, from
I think that's a lost art. You know,
cake.
Sarah Lee.
Right, no, she'd bake them.
Mm-hmm. That's neat.
They were really good.
Mm-hmm.
And then my sister made it this year as well. Mm-hmm. And it was decent.
Decent. Mm-hmm. We have something called, well, we call it Precious. And we're like, it's time for Precious. And, you know, we...
Just from Science of the Land.
From Hobbit and all that.
Oh, okay.
No.
The Precious.
But I was going to order everybody some for Christmas, and I thought that's what it was called. But it's not really called Precious. It's something else. So I couldn't find it on the internet anywhere, but it's a sticky toffee kind of stuff. And you pour this caramel over the top of it.
Mm.
You have any idea what that might be? I couldn't order it. I've got to talk to my siblings and find out what.
But there was
made it.
She ordered it from a catalog. My mom did every year.
Yeah.
But I never paid close enough attention to know what it really was.
Maybe like a Harry and David type of thing.
Yeah.
My sister is sending me something from Fiji. There's a place you can.
The island?
No, there's a place that's like David's, you know, where they send you different items, you check them, I mean, internet kind of thing, and you just mail it to whomever, you know, so that you don't have to get out and do anything. So she said she was sending me that, so that's probably candy. But I did one year, I got some moose something. I can't remember the name of the, it was popcorn, I think, with chocolate.
I know what you're talking about, yes.
And
yes.
That was delicious. And I
could be chocolate popcorn and regular popcorn,
right,
and cheese three popcorn, all these different ones.
Right.
And nuts.
Yeah. That
like,
is
yeah,
like
it is something very spectacular.
Moose something, but it's pretty good. It's by one of those companies that you can order things from, order food from.
Yeah.
So, but
If somebody doesn't do it first, I might ever order from a catalog though like that, because I wouldn't know if I really like it or not. You know, I'd wait to have somebody else.
Some of it's really good. Harriet David's really good.
I used to get my dad the Fruit of the Month Club. They have Fruit of the Month Club
really?
With Harriet David.
Neat.
So every month it would be a different
delivery of
different kind of fruit.
Really good
he loves fruit.
Fruit.
Now, weren't
he
you getting
fruit.
The bacon of the month there for a while?
Well, yes, I've gotten
bacon. Of
I like a month things.
Yeah.
Because you get something every month.
Yeah,
you keep going
neat.
For
yeah.
a little while and stuff.
Yeah. Like
that. Cheese of the month and wine of the month, bacon of the month, salsa of the month, coffee of the month. I've got all these
ones. That's really cool. Just look it up online, say that. And
Amazing Clubs is the one that I have done.
Oh,
yes. Yeah.
No,
but there are all kinds
idea.
Of things out there.
It's too late this year, but I'll think about it.
There's cookies. Actually, I got for Pigeon one year. I got chocolate of the month. Mm-hmm. There's a different chocolate item that could be delivered.
Oh,
that is incredible.
That is. That's very nice.
That.
Yeah. And for all of our viewers out there, you now know what we want for Christmas.
Yeah. All, those
all the above. Yeah. Chocolate, particularly.
Yeah, chocolate on top.
But you know, also,